can. The store was always filled with shoppers buying all sorts of things, but no one ever seemed to want a small bear in gray overalls. Then one morning, a little girl stopped and looked straight into Cornbread's bright eyes. "Oh, Mommy," she said, "look, there's a fairy bear I've always wanted." "Not today, dear," her mother sighed. "I spent too much already. Besides, he doesn't look new. He lost a button to one of his shoulder straps." Cornaway watched them sadly as they walked away. "I didn't know I lost a button," he said to himself. "Tonight I'll go and see if I can find it." Late that evening, when all the shoppers had gone and the doors were shut and locked, Cornaway climbed carefully down from his shelf and began searching everywhere on the floor for his lost button. Suddenly, he felt the floor moving under him. Quite by accident, he had stepped into an escalator, and up he went. Could this be a mountain? He wondered. I think I've always wanted to climb a mountain. He stepped off the escalator as it reached the next floor, and there, before his eyes, was a most amazing sight. Tables and chairs and lamps and sofas and rows of beds. "This must be a place." "Palace," Cornaway gasped. "I guess I've always wanted to live in a palace." He wandered around, admiring the furniture. "This must be a bed," he said. "I've always wanted to sleep in a bed." And up he crawled into a large, thick mattress. All at once, he saw something small and round. "Why, here's my button," he cried. And he tried to pick it up. But like all the other buttons on the mattress, it was tied down, tucked. He yanked and pulled with both paws until, pop, off came the button, and off the mattress Cornaway toppled. Bang! Into a tall floor lamp. Over it fell with a crash. Cornaway didn't know, but there was someone else awake in the store. The night watchman was going his rounds on the floor above. When he heard the crash, he came dashing down the escalator. "Now who in the world did that?" he exclaimed. "Somebody must be hiding around." Under and over sofas and beds until he came to the biggest bed of all. In there he saw two fuzzy brown ears sticking up from under. nothing like that enormous palace in the department store. This must be home, he said. I know I've always wanted a home. Lisa sat down with Corduroy on her lap and began to sew a button on his overalls. I like you the way you are, she said, but you'll be more comfortable with your shoulder strap fastened. You must be a friend, said Corduroy. I've always wanted a friend. Me too, said Lisa, and gave him a